searching for the things we do, yeah. Drop top without a choice, yeah. Hair blown round to the window, singing stupid noise, or will you? I just wanna get to know ya. I wanna go far to the coast, yeah. I wanna drive fast to the ocean. I wanna know all of you. Growing old like a ghost, yeah. I wanna have kids of my own, yeah. Live a life till it's over. But until we do, it's sleeping sooner. I'm feeling a little crazy. Sat at home being lazy. Wanna travel to the mighty, flying with you. Wanna take on the world and do something. Would you by my side like it's nothing? Wanna buy you things that you wanted. Wanna find you drop top without a choice, yeah. Hair blow around to the window, singing stupid noise.
Hi guys, welcome to a new video today. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Consider subscribing, it's free and you can always change your mind later on. Also, smash the like button and comment down below. And let's dive right into the video. But before we start the video, I would like to apologize for the last video for clickbaiting you guys. And yeah, the title was clickbait and you guys were clickbaited. And yeah, I apologize for that. But I'm not gonna stop doing it because it's for my channel's sake. And yeah, so please do understand that I'm gonna do it a lot more often because it's the YouTube algorithm and it gets more clicks. So yeah, that's my explanation for doing all those clickbaity title and all those clickbaity thumbnail. So yeah, that's my explanation for that, and let's get right into the video. I'm playing Wukong in the jungle today, so let's get right into it. Okay, so let's talk about the runes for this Wukong. Actually, the runes are still the same. Actually, the build is actually really new. So yeah, let's talk about the build. The runes are still the same: Conqueror, Brutal, Hunter Titan, and Mastermind. Those are the four runes I always use for my jungle. And for my build, first item would be Black Cleaver. Second item is the boots, right? So Mercury Tress or Glutinous Greaves. Or actually, you don't need Glutinous Greaves. I think you might need Mercury Tress or Steel Plated Boots. And then enchantment would either be Proto Bell or maybe Stasis, depending on the matchup. If you want to be riskier, you can go for the Proto Bell. And then after that, it would be the Solar Charge Plate. You might ask why Solari Charge Blade? Because Wukong usually always uses his abilities, like the first skill, second skill, third skill is always there. You need to combo it really good so that you can have the maximum amount of like impact in team fights. So yeah, Solari Charge Blade is really good. Plus there's attack speed in it. So yeah, as for the third next item would be GA, and we have ganking top lane. I'm just gonna keep talking about the build. GA, after that it will be defensive items, and then defensive item for the penultimate item would be the defensive item would be Seraph's Cage, and the last item would be either, you can just choose depending on the matchup, you can probably guess which item you want, depending on the matchup. Yeah, depending on the matchup, really, actually. And yeah, let's try to commentate in this fight. And we are fighting for a Cloud Drake, actually, because my team fight ability is really good. So yeah, we are just gonna keep fight for the dragon, fight for team fights, and yeah. Wukong's ability, you just need to fight a lot of team fight, actually. Like pick a really good team fight and fight it. it's gonna be really good, and then you're just gonna let your carries like do all the work. Yeah, that's basically my tips for Wukong. It's really simple actually, just that this in this video I might try to do another Wukong video, because this video is actually really crazy because of all those because it's like a we were really actually down a lot actually in this one, because it was a comeback game, spoiler. Yeah, it is a comeback game. I haven't actually get a like I actually did get a really good game with this build actually though. It's just that I didn't record it or live stream it, so I don't have the records of it. But I do have the video playback, but I don't actually like it that much, so I want to like have live gameplay for you guys. So yeah, and plus this build, I think it could easily be like a carry type of build. And now we have a fight top lane, which is not good for me because I died there. And now our ASO is here. Our ASO is really good in this one actually though. And our Jhin just snipes away with the curtain call. Double kill for our Jhin, and yeah, I have 2 deaths here. Now I'm fast forwarding in bot lane, trying to clear out the minions wave. Yeah, and now might get this turret though. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna get this turret. Just got our mid turret, baited this, but I don't have mana anymore, just gonna run away. I think Jax's jungle is actually really OP now. I don't know why, but somehow Jax found his way. I think a lot of people, I should have used my smite there. I should have used it, and I would definitely kill the Darius there, but it is what it is, right? And oh, there you go. You see the damage there? Like 600 like critical damage. The crit is really good on Wukong, so I would really you guys can really try this build. Plus it's tanky with the Black Cleaver. It's really good, so yeah. And now I'm trying to find a way to go into the fight. Might try to go here, go onto the Azul, use my ultimate. Might die here for it. Yeah, got killed. Yep. Well, and they might get Mountain Drake. Oh, that's tough. But at least we got a trade back for the Rift Herald though, so not too shabby actually. Now go in, go on to the Ezreal. Can I kill the Ezreal? Yes, let's go. And now I'm just gonna try to go back, let him. But our ASO didn't actually get it though, and I might die here. Use my ultimate again. Yeah, die to the Jax. In my opinion, Jax really does feels like a probably A tier now. Might be S tier, might be bottom of the S tier, but it actually though, I think Jax could be a counter pick for Lee Sin, but depending on, still it depends on how you play the champion, and plus you need like teammates are really good enough to like let you have like all the resources, so it's still depending on how you farm at Jax. From as Jax, so yeah, still really dependent on situation on those. I might need to do another Jax video to like update on the situation for that. So there's a lot of high elo like Jax recently like pop up everywhere, so it becomes really popular because people know how to play Jax now. And yeah, high elo players just know how to just roll over people in the late game. Plus, with Kayle, you need Jax to like negate her damage. So yeah, it became more frequent with those. And now we are trying to get away, try to face check this, because they might try to do Baron, so... fast forward now, Dragon is, Inferno Dragon is up. Use my ultimate, go on to the Katarina, use my ultimate again, don't have my ultimate now. Can I kill the Katarina? My GA pop, but double kill for the Jin, and I just missed Ezreal ult, and now our team got clapped, really clapped, and now go on to the, not enough though. Because the Ezreal was really fat at this point, plus they have the Baron buff, and they have two dragons, so if I was like actually really ahead, I would kill the Ezreal though. But I need to do another video for that, so yeah. And now we have another fight here. We caught them out in the open in our jungle. They really think we got sneaked by them, but nope. I killed the Katarina and the double kill for our Jhin. Mid lane, Jax is pushing. At this point of the game, I just said like, fuck it, just try to find a team fight that really suits us and just fight it out and let's see what goes from there. That's my mindset at this point, because you can't possibly be like thinking of like trying to push out the winners with it and waiting for death. Like Jax is really good at split pushing, so you just need to fight, just trying to fight a fight if there's a Jax. Either you killed most of his teammates or you die trying, and that's basically how I play against Jax. And yeah, counter pick to Jax, I don't think there's any counter pick. It's actually really obnoxious. Unless you have like a lot of CC, then it's a totally different situation, so you need to have like CC with to like CC Jax. And now Jax is just running us down. I'm just gonna use my clone, get away. The Jax got just baited, and our mid lane, our solo laner are filing, and he just uses his ult. I also use my ult, use my clone, use my ult again, got the Jax, and that's how I kill. That's how you gonna counter Jax. You just need like a lot of CC. Like if he jumps in, CC him, just like that. Plus it's tough to negate all those damages, and yeah. And now we have a Baron here to take it. It's a really close game. It's a close game so far. Plus they still have left their tier 2 turret up, and we only have our inhibitor up. And now we have another fight here going on with the Darius coming in, and I narrowly evaded the Ezreal ult, double kill for the Azul, and we also got the Baron, and now I'm just gonna go on to the Katarina with only half L actually though. And our Azul got a triple kill from that, and now we are just gonna push in all the way in. I think we can do it like once. Just gonna go in, use my ultimate, go in again, use my ultimate, kill this Jax, yep, there we go. And now ace for us, and we have enough damage. Wukong's Q is really really good to like push turrets, so just go in. Can we kill someone? Yep, there we go. Thank God the cannon uses ult. If not, I think we're all dead to the Katarina. And that's the end of the video, guys. Thanks for watching till the end of the video, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye, guys. Victory.